Welcome to your Tuesday One Show with Alex Jones.
And Matt Baker. But around the same time as Rob's big break in Hollywood, a punk band called The Alarm emerged from the slightly less glamorous riddle.
Yeah, now Carrie has hitched a lift in the car that drove them straight into the charts. Have a look.
68 Guns by Welsh band The Alarm was a sing-along anthem that launched them into the UK top 20 in 1983.
Set against a backdrop of mass unemployment and recession, it was a song of youthful rebellion against the expectations of society, and with a rousing chorus that was conceived in the back of an old Ford Cortina. Inspired by the emergence of punk music, lead singer Mike Peters wanted nothing more than to get away from the restrictions of living in a small seaside town in North Wales.
Punk didn't happen in real. You had to go to it. You had, you know, to get narrow trousers.
Yeah.
You couldn't just order them and have them delivered to your door. You know, you had to drive thousands of miles to get there. It felt like thousands of miles. At that time, bands could only get gigs by playing cover versions because they were there to entertain the seaside crowd, the holidaymakers, and it was a holiday camp mentality.
Mike's ambitions to break away were hugely helped by a gift of an old Ford Cortina from his granddad.
And as soon as I got behind the wheel, I knew freedom had entered my life. The fashion conscious of real would be in this car, and we would all be going to Liverpool to see gigs, Manchester. It was life-changing, but to have a car.
It was that feeling of the band and their mates forming a united front against the wider world that inspired the song 68 Guns.
I read a book called The Glasgow Gang Observed, and it was really about youth culture. It's a street corner culture, about clothes, music, belonging. You know, I was part of that culture of growing up with a gang of people, if you like, and so writing lyrics that reflected that led the way towards the song 68 Guns.
A close friend and support at the time was Gareth Jones, who later became known as TV presenter Gaz Top. He gave up his own band to become their guitar roadie.
The Alarm were never a local band. They were hard-working and professional right from the word go. That, you know, you had a mission statement, you had better songs, you were better musicians than any of us, you had hair crimpers, you had hairspray.
I think Gareth made us realise how strong the group was, to realise that we actually could break out of the confines of where we'd come from.
OK, I'm going to say one word. Cortina.
Oh.
Your first car.
Yeah, absolutely.
My favourite car of all time. Love the Cortina. How many people did you get in there?
We could get at least 11, possibly 12 at a push. We used to spend hours driving around Real in our car, nothing to do but playing music from the cassette deck.
One of their favourite songs was a cover version of I Fought the Law by punk band The Clash.
And there's a line in the song where it says robbing people with their six guns and top ahead and the drummer would rap out six beats. And of course, with Gareth in our team, the comedy comes out. And we'd all go, well, what if they had more than six guns? What would he have done? What if he'd had 68 guns? That's a great title for a song. Come on, let's go.
In 1981, The Alarm made their move to London, taking Gareth with them. Gaining a great reputation as a live band, they landed a record deal. Then their first Top of the Pops appearance sealed the band's success in the UK.
68 Guns made us known in all the households through Top of the Pops. It made our parents super proud because all of a sudden they could tell their friends that their kids had finally made it.
One, two, three, four.
Today, 35 years later, having survived cancer three times, Mike's found new meaning in the song.
My life away. Forever young, I cannot stay.
Hey!
When I was first diagnosed, I was on the way to a concert and I didn't know what to do, and all my instincts said, just go and play the gig. And as I was singing the song, the words of 68 Guns Will Never Die really spoke to me in another way altogether from how I'd originally written the song. So to me, it is a battle cry to live, to stay alive.
And Mike is now very happy to be back in Rhyl, where he's celebrated as a famous son.
It's where I belong, really. It's a Welsh word called Hiraeth.
Hiraeth, what does that mean?
To Welsh people, it just means a longing for Wales. It brings you back here all the time, and I've travelled, but I always find myself back here at the important times to be with family, the people you need around you to be able to truly live.
The 68 Guns!
Brilliant, brilliant story of the song. Earlier on today, Alex told us a brilliant story, right, about when she was a runner working for a
production
company.
Met all Mike. About the.
Hang on, hang on.
Sorry,
I tell you what.
Go on.
Actually, let's hear it from.
Oh, get
let's
off.
Let's hear it from Mike. Go on.
Alex Jones, the BBC One presenter. She was working for a television company in South Wales at one point, and she thought Mike Peters from The Alarm had come to fix the alarm in the building. So I was led to the cupboards where the alarm were fitted and told to fix them.
That's amazing. Classic Jones. Classic Jones.
Oh, he's so nice, Mike.
Yeah, brilliant.
That story's haunted me for years. Anyway, let's move on.